over in Annapolis Harbor today, looking at what we believe to be an algae bloom. One of the things that we're doing is we have a multi-probe instrument that actually gives us water chemistry readings, including pH and dissolved oxygen and temperature, which are some of the factors that actually induce these growths. What I'm going to do now is take a sample, and we're going to take it back to the lab and look at it under the microscope to identify it and see what kind of species it is. Yep, protocentrum mineral. Primarily what this bloom is composed of is called a dinoflagellate. It's basically a single-celled organism. They have the ability to swim around through the water column, and what they really need to survive are two things. They need light, and they also need nutrients. And nutrients are something that we're really concerned about in Chesapeake Bay. This algae really has taken on early, not only because of the warming temperatures, but also the nutrient influx that was associated with the storms last summer. When you have excess nutrients, too much nutrients on our fields and in our gardens, all those constituents will end up in the water column. The algae we're seeing here today in Annapolis is not considered harmful to humans. However, we are very concerned that if it blooms and successionally blooms, in other words, one bloom dies off followed by the nutrient release and a second bloom, that this thing could really grow very large and cause a severe oxygen demand in the water column. So at this point, we're gonna wait with bated breath to see how the summer progresses with these blooms.